It was a great freshman season for Danny Mac, but he wasn't satisfied. He felt that he could have done more to earn that starting spot, and wants to prove this year he's the best back in the conference. All offseason, he spent time in the lab studying film, watching some of the greats like Emmitt Smith, Thurman Thomas, Walter Payton, just to name a few. He went to practice trying to use what he learned in the film room on the field, and it worked. You can see his confidence growing, and his ball-carrying vision got better. Going into the sophomore campaign, Dan got faster, his carrying got better, and the elusiveness is going to allow him to get more wiggle. The weight room was Danny's best friend. He got stronger, and he's been working on that juke move. Now it's time to get serious. It's game day. And first up for the Red Wolves are the Idaho Vandals. We jump to mid-first quarter. Danny comes out running the wheel route. He makes a tough grab and picks up 13. Two plays later, he gets his first carry. He sheds one tackle, tries to juke, but gets stuffed for no gain. Next A-State possession, Danny takes the handoff, tries to bounce it outside, but gets gang tackled, and is a three-yard loss. It's third and long for the Red Wolves. Danny comes out of the backfield, makes the catch in front of the linebacker, and powers his way to 16. Start of second, Danny out for another route, and he has tons of space. He turns upfield and bowls over a corner, stumbles and picks up 19. After an A-State TD, Danny is out for another pass. He runs the wheel route again, makes the catch, and picks up 14. Later drive, coach calls the seam route for Danny. He breaks it off across the middle, makes the catch, and turns on the Jets. He cuts back inside and gets into the end zone. What a run by Danny Mac. We jump ahead to the third. Danny takes the power right, follows his blockers, cuts upfield, and powers his way down to the one-yard line. Next play, you got to finish what you start. Danny powers his way into the end zone. That's his second TD on the day. Later in the third, Dan takes a delay, makes a cut right, gets great downfield blocking, and is pulled down after a 15-yard pickup. Then Danny takes the pitch out right, cuts upfield, and picks up another 7 yards. Another third and long for the Red Wolves. Danny comes out of the backfield, cuts across the middle, and makes the grab. He breaks away from the linebacker and gets out to the 30-yard line. After a Red Wolves field goal, Danny takes the stretch right, cuts it back inside, and picks up 6. Then on third and four, Danny gets it again. He gets caught up in a pile, but breaks out. He hits the sideline and gets pulled down after a huge gain. After a touchdown by both teams, Danny comes out running hard. He cuts it back inside. Then he bounces it outside and turns on the burners. Danny Mac goes 75 yards to the house for his third TD on the day, and it's his longest of his career. A-State up 17, and Danny looks to put the game away, hitting the trap up the middle, weaving, and picking up 14. A few plays later, Danny gets it again, cuts up the middle, tries to bounce it out left and gets the Red Wolves inside the red zone. Next play, Danny shows off the vision, cutting it back inside, taking a hit, and stumbling for 9 yards. And that would do it. Arkansas State starts off their season beating down Idaho 38-21. And what a day for Danny Mac. 19 carries for 205 yards, 2 touchdowns, and add on 6 grabs for 121 yards and another score. Great opening game for the sensational sophomore and the Red Wolves. Up next, another stat-packing game against FCS. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure you smash that thumbs up button and subscribe if you're brand new. And don't forget to hit those links down in my description and follow your boy on Facebook, Twitter, and IG at Big C Gat Game. Have a great day, guys. 2 fingers in the air. Peace.